The Goalseek function allows you to generate a required result by automatically changing an identified input cell. In this example, we have a simple spreadsheet where we have the sales price, some units sold over various months, the cost of sale percentage, and the resultant gross profit. Let's say we want to find out how, by changing the sales price, we can achieve a gross profit of 200. To activate the Goalseek, you click on Tools, Goalseek, and this box will pop up. And what you'll see, it says, tell me which cell I must set. In this case, we want that cell to be set. It asks you for what value it must go to. So we want it to go to 200. And it asks what cell needs to be changed to achieve this result. And in this case, we know it's the sales price. It is important to remember that the cell that you're going to change has to be an input. It cannot be a formula. So if we click OK, you'll see it goes through and gives you a result that results in the result you want. And it says, I found a solution. Is that OK? And we can push OK. In a similar way, let's say we now want to get a gross profit of 250 by changing the cost of sale percentage. So we click on Tools, Goalseek, and we say set this cell, which is correct, to a value of 250 by changing our cost of sale percentage. And when we press OK, we'll see that it tells us in order to get a gross profit of 250, the cost of sale percentage needs to be about 25%. You can also perform Goalseek straight off a graph. So if we say OK here, maybe we think this graph looks a bit funny and the sales in month three are a bit high. If you click on the graph on that bar, you'll see that it highlights all the bars. If you click on it again, you'll see it highlights only the month three bar. And if you go towards the top, you'll see the cursor changes and you can actually drag it down. When you let go, you'll see it immediately says, okay, it looks like you want to change cell E4, which is over here, to a value of 134. What cell must I change to achieve this? And in this case, we want to change the unit sold. And when we click OK, you'll see it generates the number of units sold to meet your particular requirements. And again, you can, once you're happy with that, you can say OK.